Hi, and welcome in another video of Cloud in 5 Minutes. Today, I want to talk about a feature that I've been waiting for years. It's finally possible to create static website in Azure Blob Storage. Woohoo! Aussi, si vous préférez, j'ai une version en français de ce vidéo. Cliquez juste ici, en haut à droite. Okay, before I get started, I just want to do a little parentheses here. I just want to explain why I was so happy that the website was now available in the Blob Storage. Well, cloud is really great when you got fluctuation, when traffic change in time. Azure was not really offering like a great solution if you had like simple website that didn't change in time. So now, with the static website in the Blob Storage, you will have high availability and it will be cheap. So earlier this week, this post was published, and honestly, it made my day. I was so happy to see it. In it, you will see here in the Get Started section all the tools that are available to play with the Azure website. Right now, at the moment when I'm recording this video, the feature is still in preview. So the service worked great, however, the tools are not there yet. I'm sure it will be coming pretty fast. I will talk a little bit more about it later. You have many different options to create your storage and your static website, but today I want to show you how to do it through the portal. So in the portal, you will create a storage account like usual, except for one thing. Here, when it specifies Azure Kind, you need to pick the General Purposes V2. In the article I was talking about, it's just mentioned that you need to pick the GP V2. So GP V2 was exactly for general purposes V2. So once you create that, everything will be fine and you will have like your storage account. In fact, I already have one created, and the difference when you create your account is here you will have where it is here, the static website preview. And if you click on that, you can enable your static website and you will have your URL. Here it is. If I go there right now, of course, I have nothing. No content. But that's what we expect. Perfect. So now we have our shell, it's time to put some content in it. Of course, I could have done all manually, but I want to leverage one tool that I pretty like, and it's Jekyll. I don't know if you know it. It's a tool that I like. It's generate website and blogs and things like that, so it's very efficient. Well, I will put the link in the description. Comment is just Jekyll, new, and then the name of your website. We'll generate everything for you. Voila. And now you just need to change to that folder. Perfect. I just want to show you first. So let's use code. So here in Visual Studio Code, I see all my configuration, and this is a blog, so I have many posts. If I want to add new, then I just add new files in the post section, and then I need to generate my static content. So I could put stuff there and it will be generated to a static website. To do that, I just need to do Jekyll and build it. What happens now, it will create a subfolder called underscore site. And if we have a look here, this is all static. Now I want to specify to my Azure website that my initial file is index.html. So to do that, I need to go in the portal and here, and I got myself fooled once because it was written already, but in gray. So I need to put it like that and save it. So to upload the file, of course, I could go in the overview in the blob section and upload. Now you will see a new container called $web. That's our folder. So I could have upload that directly, but it will be file by file. They have no way to upload all the file or a folder directly. So it was long. So I decided to try different things. So of course I try scripting. So if we go back in Visual Studio Code, okay, so first was easy copy. I tried, I was getting an error. I think it's just because right now easy copy is not yet up to date. It doesn't like, I think, the $web, and it will be the same for Azure Storage and like I was trying doing batch, and even one by one, it didn't work. So it was not working for me, but like I said, it's still in preview, and I'm pretty sure the tool will be fixed shortly. Or it could be me. Maybe I'm doing something wrong. So if you figured it out, let me know. We'll be very happy. So I try using the Azure CLI extension. So the Azure CLI was really great to create or update your static website, but to upload, it didn't help much. So even when I installed that, it didn't help. Then I try the Visual Studio Code preview. That worked well, so we'll do that today. I will put all the link in the description. So in Visual Studio Code, of course, you will need to have the storage extension, and you will install the preview version. To activate it, you need to do Control comma, and then set here. Whoops, let me minimize this. And you need to add this setting here. It's all specified in the post, and I will put all those URL inside the description of this video. So once you got that set, now if we go back in the extension, we navigate through our storage, then the blob. Of course, we'll find the $web container, and now we'll have like deploy website, static website. That's perfect. So we click here and we'll browse and we'll take the site. Voila. And then we just click OK. So wait a little bit. And now if we go back here and we refresh, voila, we have our website. So now I have a nice blog post that is completely static, hosted in Azure Blob Storage. Woohoo! This option suits very well the website for an event, for a landing page, if you have a blog, if you just want like a little family website with a bunch of photo and everything, it will be very, very cheap. I will put all the useful information, post and URL inside the description. And if you have any questions, let me know. I will be super happy to help you. I hope you liked this video and I hope it was useful. Thank you for watching. See you next time.